Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to today's Vanarama National League South clash between Eastbourne Borough and Bar City, live from Priory Lane. I'm Mark Stillman, commentating throughout with Michael Powell on summarising duties. It's a 350-mile round trip for the Romans this afternoon as they take on the in-form Sports, who have won their last four to take advantage of fellow playoff contenders floundering. They came unstuck at Tullerton Park, but will be keen for revenge on this non-league day at a venue which has seen a hefty 57 goals this season. Indeed, there hasn't been a 0-0 here in National League South since Bath City visited in March 2019. Jerry Gill's men are unbeaten in four in what's been a positive fortnight, which has also seen them reach the Somerset Premier Cup final in May. Hopefully we'll be treated to another exciting match this afternoon. Danny Bloor applauding the fans just in front of us. He's a manager who goes for the suited and booted look. Jerry Gill already in his dugout with his coaching staff. So I'll go through the starting lineups of both teams this afternoon. Start with the hosts, Eastbourne Borough, have made two changes from last week's win over Hungerford. In goal is Lee Morgan. They're playing 4-2-3-1 incidentally. Fullbacks of Jake Elliott and Jack Curry, who's back into the team for Luke Nippard. Centre-backs Mitch Dickinson and Trent Mahorn. Two holding midfielders of Jaden Perez and James Hammond. Three in front of them. On the right will be Greg Lure. Through the middle, Charlie Walker. And on the left back into the team is Chris Welkdale for the injured Dom Hutchinson. And up front on his own, leading goal scorer Charlie Kendall. On the bench for Eastbourne, Joel Rollinson, the returning Kai Wallard-Innocent, who was on loan here last season, James Vaughan, Leon Gravato, scored at Tullerton Park, and Finn Holter. For Bath City, one change from last week's win over Hemel Hempstead Town. Cody Cook is in for Dave Sims-Burgess. I believe they're playing a 4-4-2 diamond. In goal is Ryan Clark. Fullbacks of Eddie Jones and Zach Delaney. Centre-backs Jordan Dyer and Jack Batten. Joe Range just in front of them. Ryan Jones and Elliot Freer playing behind Tom Smith, and then the front two of Cody Cook and Alex Fletcher. On the bench of our city, Omar Holness, Dan Ball, Tom Richards, Dave Sims-Burgess and Will Fuller. The officials, the referee is a late change, is now Ben Atkinson. Last time he took charge of a city match was the Boxing Day 2020 draw with Chippenham Town, where he sent off a player for each team. He'll be assisted by Chris Britton and Kieran Fiddler. Bath City are wearing black and white shirts, white shorts and white socks. Eastbourne in their traditional red shirts, black shorts and red socks as the Eastbourne team going for a huddle while the captains meet in the middle. Our break off now, as I mentioned before, we will now be holding a minute's silence for Michael Sindicum, a club stalwart who passed away today.
Yeah, it's always nice to see when clubs recognise long-standing fans, isn't it? He's obviously been an Eastbourne fan for many years, supported the club, been to lots of games, and it always feels appropriate when people like that are recognised, because they're the lifeblood of non-league clubs, aren't they?
Absolutely. In a few moments' time, the referee will blow his whistle and the stadium will fall into a polite silence. He blows his whistle again to end the minute silence for Michael Sindicum. Free Ben Atkinson checks that everything is in order, and away we go. Mahorn picks it up midway inside his own half. Ball takes deflection over to the left hand side. It's now picked up from Welpdale. Tried to play it behind him, but Ryan Jones picks it up. Elliott on the right slips it behind. It's a good ball actually to Kendall. Forced to go back to Walker, and a rather tame shot. It's blocked from Jones, and Walker clearly barges through the back of Reigns. Hanging one from Freer. It was nearly onto the head of Fletcher, but it's helped away, and now Walker can try and lead a counter for Eastbourne. Plays it behind to Lur. Cuts inside of Eddie Jones. City will be exposed at the moment, and a ball forward is two over hit from Walker. Does he get away with it? They're back in possession now with Button. Lovely ball over to the right hand side. Nice touch from Jones to Fletcher near the corner of the penalty area. Curry thoughts twice about the challenge. Nice Smith bringing it in, trying to turn away. He's got near the byline, and final touch goes behind for another City corner as Freer takes his latest one. Near the 6-yard box, is headed away from Welpdale. Smith was in there, back to Fletcher. to the taker, Freer, getting towards the byline. Got past Walker with ease, chips it back towards the back post. It's not fully headed away to Smith, who volleys it and is blocked. I think it might have been Worgan, the goalkeeper, who got in the way. It was a defender near the line as well, but first real meaningful effort from Bow City. They're still in possession with range just past halfway. A glorious ball over to the left-hand side, which walked down from Freer. Can he put in another teasing ball? He can't. He's prevented on this occasion from Walker, but Eastbourne lucky to escape that.
Yeah, it was a floated ball from Freer. The header away was poor, came to Smith, caught it first time on the volley, didn't quite catch all of it, but yeah, still a good save by Worgan at his near post.
Range is almost like a corner, actually. And it's held in. Oh, and again, it gets a flick off an Eastbourne player. Couldn't quite land for Cook, is behind for another corner, but these are causing Eastbourne a few problems. Ryan Jones to take this corner. Certainly gets some whip on it and flicks behind off Elliot. Bow City enjoying a lot of possession in these early stages. Now Ryan Jones skips away from Whelpdale. Plays a nice ball to Delaney on this left-hand side. Brings it under control to Freer, again on the left. Delaney's made an overlapping run near the byline. Floats one towards the back post. Oh, Fletcher couldn't connect with it. Goalkeeper was caught unawares. I think the float of the board caught him out. Eastbourne have not looked convincing thus far. Here's Ryan Jones in behind to Fletcher on the right. Should keep him by the byline. Oh, he just evades Smith. Bow City are really piling on the pressure. They just can't get that luck in front of goal. Smith plays it across. It's too high for Fletcher. Head away from Dickinson. Picked up from Ryan Jones. Chips it again back inside. Fletcher chests it down. Back to Delaney with the left foot. Oh, it wasn't goal words. It was cleared from Dickinson. Bow City have started really well here, Michael.
Well, I said after that first 2 minutes, they've been well on top. They're by far the better team. You just feel like they have to make it count because it's one-way traffic at the moment.
Here's Lurdo on the right-hand side. Walker tries to slip it behind Elliot, but it's intercepted. Picked up from Rains on halfway. Cleverly plays it inside to Smith. He's got Cook in room on his right-hand side. He's going central at the moment. Under pressure from Perez, he shoots and Perez comes back and blocks it. Now breaks to Whelpdale, just inside his own half. And returning to the starting 11 this afternoon to Kendall. They want to get him in the game as often as possible. He's running towards the side of the penalty area. He's gone down very easily and he goes behind for a goal kick. I think he's just lost his balance, I'm not sure.
Yeah, it was very, very little in that for me. He's just gone down looking for a free kick, maybe a penalty because it was right on the edge of the box.
Corner which Jones is going to take. Again, gets some whip on it, and he only went straight in, actually. It goes out of play. City are appealing that Worgan got a touch. Mahorn in possession. Takes it past halfway. Plays it out to Elliot on this right-hand side. Tried to lure. Back to Elliot. And Kendall comes back to pick up the ball. Elliot again, approaching forward. He's going to try and slip it behind. There's a chance for Kendall. He scored his 20th goal of the season. It was very easy, actually. Elliot just threaded it through. Kendall had half a sight on goal and he wasn't going to miss. 24 minutes, Eastbourne 1, Bow City 0.
Yes, that movement we talked about with Kendall just finds a pocket of space in between the centre-back and the full-back. It's an excellently timed run. Pass to him is timed perfectly well. Bow City would feel like they could have defended it better. They need to be tighter to him. You know he's going to try and find that movement. And if you give someone of Charlie Kendall's quality a one-on-one inside the area, he's generally going to make you pay. And that's exactly what he's done with his 20th league goal of the season.
Kendall's beaten in the air from Dyer, but onto the loose ball is Walker now, 30 yards out, charging forward. Walker, shot takes deflection off Dyer and goes behind for a corner. Again, it looked a little bit too easy to me. Goes short to Elliot. Tried to play it back to Curry, miscontrolled. Still manages to get a ball in and then he found Whelpdale at the far post with a little touch in the middle, took it away. He's still got it. Left-sided player on his right foot towards Dickinson, who heads it wide. And Hammond wins the ball near his box and Reigns jumps with Walker. Ryan Jones tries to force his way through, can do so. Reigns has won the ball and tries to curl it into the back post, but doesn't trouble Worgan. It goes around a yard wide. It's nice Smith near the edge of the penalty area. Exchanges passes with Fletcher. This is better. Nice Smith into the box, trying to force his way through. Couldn't quite do it. Now Reigns, the left-footed effort. He's hammered it straight against the unfortunate Smith, who blocked it. Here's Reigns, just past halfway. Allowed to go forward to Smith now, near the edge of the box. Smith, oh, he tried to run to Kirk. He perhaps could have been more selfish and had to go himself. Only cleared as far as Button to Reigns. trying to turn away from two men. He does with ease. Still range near the edge of the penalty area. Squares it to Ryan Jones. Got Fletcher in room on the right-hand side. Eyed up from Curry. Fizzes it across and it's straight against Cook, who had no chance of bringing it under control. A bit better from Bouncy. Just needed to get that telling ball in. Referee looks at his watch. Whistle to his lips, and that is the end of the first half. It's Eastbourne who will go into the break the happier. Number 24, Charlie Kendall, scoring in the 24th minute. Assist from Jake Elliott, his 22nd goal of the season in all competitions. And that goal has changed the performance levels, really, for Eastbourne, who started slowly. Bath City were the better team, but Eastbourne have looked more confident since they've taken the lead, and Bath City trail at the break. As City get this second half underway. Range is immediately charged down from Kendall. It's not the best start. Button helps it into the air. Reigns plays it towards the left. It's easy intercept from Whelpdale. He might fancy a go. He does shoot, and he was aiming for that bottom right-hand corner. Clark's bottom right-hand corner, who did enough to fist it behind. But 20 seconds into the second half, it's been all Eastbourne because City are giving it away straight away. Whelpdale, he brings it under control and lays it off to Walker. Lures in room on the right-hand side. Instead, it's Whelpdale, who's keen to get involved. Plays sort of left of this three behind Kendall, but darts all over the place. Now Kendall has won it far too easy in the attacking third. It's left, it's for Walker, who slashes it wide from 15 yards. That should have been 2-0.
Barton need to wake up. They haven't got going in this second half. First 2 minutes have been all Eastbourne, dominating possession, dominating territory, two dangerous long-range strikes.
Still got it, Reigns. Up to Cook near the edge of the box. Cook, good strong challenge over Mahorn. Prevents him going any further. Now Whelpdale, striding past halfway, lures in room on the right-hand side, collects it, the Eastbourne number nine, cutting infield onto his left foot, might fancy a go, he's been allowed to wander across. It's a shot on the turn, it's an easy goal for Eastbourne, it's Perez from 16 yards, again it came through the middle. Jaden Perez scored in the last home game against Dorking, he scored in this one here, and on 49 minutes, Eastbourne 2, Barca team nil.
Well, we said Eastbourne had started the second half on the front foot, had been the better team, and again Bar City lost the ball high up the pitch. It was 4-on-4 for a second, played out to Lua on the right, and just way too easy, wanders almost half the way across the pitch, nobody really puts a tackle in, slides the ball into Perez in the area, and he's goal side of the defender. It's good first time finish past Clark, but again there's just not enough pressure on the ball from Bar City.
Curry's going to take, left-footed, it'll be an in-swinger. Oh, it appeals for a foul, I presume, from Whelpdale. He almost gave up trying to win his follow-up header, where Fletcher can stride out. Looking for their fifth league win in a row, as Hammond with a nice ball to the right-hand side, where it's well brought down from Elliott. Gets onto his left foot, it's headed away from Button, near the penalty spot. It's now to Whelpdale's shot, is blocked. He looked like he was going to follow it first time, but back onto the loose ball now with Curry towards the back post, heading away from Dyer before Clark gather. Dave Sims-Burgess and Omar Holness taking off Elliot Freer. I think Tom Smith might be the other man coming off. Indeed he is. Chipped over, really good ball actually from Dyer to Eddie Jones. Low ball in towards Cook, well cleared from Mahorn, but City again more joy down this right hand side. Something looked a little bit brighter as Whelpdale escapes from Fletcher, who held him a couple of times, and good referee, he's gone back to the initial foul from Fletcher. In the 70th minute, Alex Fletcher becomes the first man into the book this afternoon. See what they can do with this corner, which Ryan Jones will take. He'll be in charge of Roland now that Freer's left the field. Left-footed, Sims-Burgess heads it against the floor, and it's only just helped over from Morgan. It nearly slipped through his hands, actually. I think he's relieved to see it bounce onto the roof of the net rather than in it. Ryan Jones to take, one arm in the air. Bit further back this time, it's one under control from Dyer, who shoots, it's blocked from a combination of Walker and Whelpdale, and cleared in the end on the back line from Hammond. It's now one for Kendall to chase. Delaney's done well, put him under pressure. He thinks the last touch is off Kendall. The officials don't. It's a throw in the Eastbourne. Couldn't skip inside. He was blocked from Ryan Jones. And the assistant flags for a throw-in. ball is cleared from Perez straight against the flag, knocks out of his hand. He chips it forward, but Button intercepts it well. Sims Burgess is going to get a yellow here for catching Dickinson a bit late. It's a little harsh. Sims Burgess is cautioned on 79 minutes. Curry on the left-hand side, charging towards the byline, plays it inside to Willard Innocent. Bring it across goal, it just misses Kendall. A bit too easy, really, for him to fizz it across, and City are lucky that they aren't trailing by three goals. Dyer picks up the loose ball in midfield. Cook plays over the top. Good ball to Sims Burgess on the right. Fletcher's waiting in the middle. Sims Burgess near the byline. Good covering, though, from Curry. He's done exceptionally well because, according to the officials, the last touch is off Sims Burgess, who sarcastically applauds the assistant, which isn't wise when you're on a yellow card. Perhaps try and nick just a consolation. He failed to score again. Scored in the last couple, of course, in this mini unbeaten run as Dyer plays it near the corner of the penalty area. It holds up. Fletcher's beaten in the air from man of the match, Mahorn. Perez scored the second goal onto Willard Innocent. It's passed halfway. Dyer took a chance diving in. Referee plays advantage. And there is one because Kendall near the edge of the box. Kendall can really seal it. Hits the inside of the post and stays out. And it remains at 2-0. That was close. It's going to be another long one for Reigns. Perhaps City's last of the afternoon. They trail 2-0. Reigns gets it. All sorts of shirt pulling. It's picked up from Fletcher and he just might got a shot away. It's blocked from Elliott. Helped back in towards Sims Burgess and Hammond gets away. Willard Innocent gets his body in the way. The ball comes last off Eddie Jones behind for a goal kick. And I think that will be the final kick of this contest. No, he's not even going to have time to. That's it here at Priory Lane. Bath City's mini revival is over. They've fallen to defeat here by 2-0. Scorers Charlie Kendall on 24 minutes and Jaden Perez on 49. Bath City started the game brightly. First 20 minutes or so, they had a couple of glimmers, good openings. But from, you say, goals change games, well, the opening one certainly did here. From then, Eastbourne were pretty much in control. Bath City didn't really look like they were getting way back into it. Once again, they fall into a side at the top end of the table. Eastbourne make it 5 wins in a row to keep up their playoff push, and you would write them off a promotion if they carry on with results like this, Michael.
No, they're a team in very good form, aren't they, Eastbourne Borough? And I think that's why the first goal was so critical as well, because once they got that goal, you just saw their confidence picked up. 5 wins on the trot in the playoffs, at home in front of a good crowd, and they're a very good team. We talked about, they keep the ball really well, and once they have the lead, if you've got an ability to do that, then you're going to be a really hard team to break down and come back against. And that's what Bath City faced this afternoon. They've got strong physical players as well. Talked about Mahorn and Dickinson at the heart of the defence, Elliott on the right. They're 3 big strong defenders, got some very good creative players in midfield, comfortable on the ball, and obviously the movement of Kendall up front, which always gives them an out ball. I think that's the other thing, him just picking up pockets of space down the channel. So, no, you'd have to say, if Bath City had scored in the opening 20 minutes when they were on top, then maybe it might have been a different game, but they didn't. And once Eastbourne Borough went in front, they did show their class this afternoon.
Thank you very much for accompanying me on our longest trip of the season this afternoon, Michael. Of course, we'll be back on our next Saturday from 2:45 p.m. for the visit of Dulwich Hamlet at Tuerton Park. Well, Eastbourne Borough have not finished above 10th in the last 11 completed seasons. Look almost certain to now as the Sports defeat the Stripes thanks to goals in each half from Charlie Kendall and Jaden Perez. 2-0 to the home side, which was enough against the Romans, whose 4-game unbeaten run is over. They'll be looking to recover in 7 days' time. From myself and Michael from the seaside, thank you very much for tuning in this afternoon and enjoy the rest of your weekend.